Right, what's going on, guys? Welcome to episode number one of my Sunderland career mode on FIFA 17. I know it's a bit belated. FIFA 17's been out for about almost a month now. I'm just trying to figure out the weeks. I think it's like 4 weeks tomorrow, I think, since it's been out. But it doesn't matter, because like, I'm now going to leave you guys my Sunderland career mode. We had to do two votes in order to... Hang on. Yeah, I forgot to do that. Message just remembered. But we had two votes to see what I'll be doing in the screen. If you guys want the career mode, first of all, that's the first vote, and there was two votes to one for yes. And the second one, which you guys now find out the results, is the board is the what you guys want to achieve. Once again, there was three votes. There was one vote for win the league and the cup, and there's two votes to win the cup. So basically, I am going to be winning. My main objective in this season is to be win either the cup, the EFL Cup, or the FA Cup. Obviously, someone win for the league. If I can, I will try and win the league as like a secondary option. Avoid relegation and win the league by itself, that you want to vote for. But I'm going to forget my board expectations anyway. So my domestic success is low. My continental success is low, which I'm assuming the Champions League, Europa League, etc. Well, that's obviously low because we're not in that. But domestic success is pretty low because I'm not really expected to win anything. And board expectations, brand exposure is not medium, so like they do want us to like try and get like shirts and kits and that with players' names on the back, and etc. Financial is high, so like they really do like make sure we don't like spend like too much money. And I completely apologize about that, guys. My control is complete. I just got my control and everything completely went out. Oh god, this is embarrassing. Put the batteries back in, and I lost all sound. But yeah, as I was saying, they actually do keep mind if we do spend a lot of money and do this. Sorry about this, guys. There we go. Yeah, so they are worried if we do spend a lot of money. And that's when the youth development's low. Again, I'm not surprised, but like, we've already got a pretty different youth team. I'll show you the starting 11. Two teams got my second team and the first team. So, sorry, the first team. We've got Manoni in goal, Performan, Keo, Kone, Didola, Bodji, and Van Aanholt. Midfield three of Catamol, Kirchhoff and Dong. On the front we've got Barini, Kasri and Defoe. Second team we've got Pickford and Gold, defensive Love, O'Shea, Denai and Jones. In midfield McNair, Rodwell and Loss. In the front we've got Yanazai, Pienaar and Anicha B. Now two we've got, obviously you've got up to development players. We're going to be training Pickford, Denaya, Gooch, Watmore and Asoro. We're in the European International Cup. We're in the group with Frankfurt, Lille and Hamburg. Without further ado, let's get on with the cream mode. There we go. Button I always like to press to get the cream mode started. Don't want what wants to play. Not in this game, sorry mate. I've got a first game against Lille. I'm going to be simulating all these games. I'm not really bothered about the international cup, because we'll get money anyway if you do progress. First game, we won 4-1. Batlam and Dong and Kadri got one goal. Each of the four got two. A good start, 4-1 win. I think Lille are actually in the top of the League Un in real life, so League Un. So we have another training session here, the second one actually. Everyone got D's, Gooch and Dan got A's, and what got C. So we're switching for second team of the game against Hamburg, who drew against Frankfurt. I think two German teams in one tournament, not in one group, sorry. It's a competition held in Germany. So that probably would be expected. We've got a second game here and we lost 1-0 and then each of you got an injury. Oh dear. And I know what like the injuries on this game, like they are absolutely ridiculous. But okay, that one was not each of only after 3 days, which is alright. We really didn't lose that game, which is not good. We've got a game against Frankfurt. So actually it's good if we win, because we do win, then we don't have nothing to worry about getting eliminated. It's only Frankfurt and Hamburg are playing each other. So basically we have to beat Frankfurt in order to go through to the next round and see what happens. Come on, we should be able to beat Frankfurt. We got a decent enough squad to be doing well in this pre-season tournament. Let's have a look, and we won 3-0, of course. And Yanazai, Defoe, and Kasri all got goals. Very well done. Now to progress to semi-final, we'll be playing Red Bulls Leipzig. No, I didn't say that. We got 1.1 million to put for progressing to the semi-finals, which is good. Got another training session. Things are going pretty well at the minute. And I don't know, Sora gone F, not good. I think Nasora's probably our most promising youth player at the moment that's like not in like the first team like all the time. I think in terms of like our youth players on the first team now, Pickford and Watmore, I think Pickford's probably more like promising than Watmore is at the moment. So got a semi-final against Leipzig. It looks like they came second in their group. See what happens, and we win 3-0. Yanazayev's two, and then Ichibi got a goal. Larsen missed a penalty, so could win 4-0, but it doesn't matter, we just win anyway. And now for the final, which means we're going to get more money, I'm going to play against Darmstadt. Two emails, first comment from the board, so we've got 2.5 million there, so now we've got sort of 3.6 million in the transfer key. Hands off for Vito Minoni from Middlesbrough, as if we do not. Especially since Middlesbrough are going to be our rivals for this season. Even though Middlesbrough are actually on the board from North Yorkshire and the North East, they are still going to be technically our Premier League rivals because they are the closest team to us. Obviously, because Newcastle are down in the Championship, and I just deleted that email, god damn. Anyway, obviously Newcastle are down in the Championship at the minute. And Jesus Christ, I'm not bothered about French conferences. I got first game of the final against Darmstadt. I hope we would do win this. It looks like they've won every single game in this tournament, so this actually could be a quite difficult game. And we won 2-0 Yanazai and Kadri, which means we win the tournament. Very good play, lads. Very good play indeed. Tournament prize money, 2.9 million. So that means we've now got, we might be won 6.5, actually our total 6.6 million, the grab to win and win it, which is good. Another this time it was Gooch. He needs some more discipline. He needs to work harder, Gooch. Here we go. We're gonna just progress forward to this season. But before I do that, I'm gonna want to loan a couple of the youth players out. Don't know what I'm doing there. So we're gonna loan out a couple of players. So we're gonna keep a Soro because we're gonna loan out Josh Marjo, literally been on the first team recently. We're gonna loan out Ethan Robson. Max Rajek, as he is our fourth keeper, so we can loan him out. Robson, I'm gonna send out loan and only keep him, but like, since we've got Donald Love and Billy Jones, we've got back cover for Van Aanholt. Greenwood, I'm gonna loan out. Looks decent. Bidling, I'm gonna loan out. I think we have enough centre backs. Gooch, I'm gonna keep. Honeyman, I'm gonna loan out. Then I'm gonna obviously I have to keep Love, McNair, and Azai. I think that's pretty much it. That's all the players I want to loan out. Hopefully, we've got some more, free up some wage. All that good stuff. Chelsea sign a Bamyang. If Chelsea do sign a Bamyang, then that could be pretty dangerous for us. Well, hopefully it doesn't happen, but if it does, then we are screwed. No, extra time, yeah, that's good. Out of all the players, I think looks like Denai is probably the closest to be the first player to grow. Obviously progressing on. Obviously FIFA 17 recently had a new update, and they now have the official sponsor of the Premier League. Well, isn't really sponsored for like, did you have a sponsorship for like, do you know the last two FIFAs that had like, the proper like Premier League, obviously it was sponsored by Barclays, I don't know if it still is now. When it was sponsored by Barclays, I had like the official like sponsorship and everything, so I had like the score, like the scoreboard thing, like the, could keep the score on that. All that was like in Premier League form, obviously this year. Beginning, obviously we were back to like FIFA's like default, but because of the new update, they have changed it now that it's back now. You guys probably have no idea what I'm talking about, but you'll see it in the next episode, hopefully. I'm gonna have a training session here. Still no loan for 20 players. I'm not too concerned though, because we'll hopefully have some before the transfer window closes. And we actually haven't got many players to loan out anyway. What will go on F? God damn. Yeah, Orange got down 70 here. I wonder why. Obviously, the ratings are still bugged, I can tell. I actually did like test cream mode before. I've played the matches, we're doing alright. Like, before the season even started, I had 73 rating, and I don't know how, because like, I did alright. Like, I got knocked out of the semi final of the tournament, but it doesn't really matter. But literally nothing happened, and I got downgraded to 73. Like, I don't know what's going on. EA need to fix the rating, manager rating. Because it's just doing like, just like getting going down for like no reason. It better not happen all the time because I'm literally going to get annoyed if it does. But guys, that is going to be a wrap for episode 4. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you enjoyed, be sure to smash the like button. Also, subscribe if you're new because subscribing makes you feel good and you'll never miss an episode. Also, just before I end the video, I just want to ask you guys, do you want me to make any signings? Because I've not done any yet. I have enabled the transfer window and I have got How do I get into the thing? I think it's on here. Ah, no, that's not us. How do I do negotiations? I don't know how to get onto the. I think maybe it's on touch player. No, it's not. I don't know how to get onto the. Hang on, it's on. It's on to negotiations. So, okay, guys. But I have at least 30. I think almost 40 million to spend. I am away. Actually, no, it's an office, isn't it? Yeah, it's in finances. There we go. So yeah, guys. I have my budget. I've got 60 million to spend. And I got 100,000 on wage. So if you guys want me to make an attendance, I will leave another vote that you can do. Or you can just vote in the comments if you want, because I know, because Liam's told me that that's when there's a link I leave to my votes. It doesn't really work a lot. Big thank you guys for watching, and see you next time for episode 2.